Don, thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
First, let's talk about the financial services industry. Where do you think it stands when it comes to AI adoption?
I think from the beginning, the financial services industry was ripe for adoption of generative AI in particular, and for a variety of reasons. First and foremost, financial services has been actually very, very familiar with traditional AI for a long period of time. There are a lot of inefficient sort of operations that are ripe for disruption. And then similarly, there's a whole slew of unstructured data that hasn't yet been harnessed. So from the beginning, it seemed like it was just a great fit for financial services to have generative AI come into the fold.
So how can these companies really push forward?
First and foremost, I think most financial services companies that have really led the way have done a lot of experimentation. They've tried to understand what areas generative AI can get traction in. They've done a lot of experiments. They've done proofs of concept. And ultimately, they've tried their best to scale them into production as well.
What do you think the future holds when it comes to these companies using GenAI?
I think the companies that are going to be most successful are going to build this muscle to iteratively experiment with different solutions and then ultimately understand how to operationalize these. I think a lot of companies have challenges when they go from POC phase into the production phase. And I think the way to navigate that is to actually think about the operationalization and the change management that's needed to have something be ingrained into a business process and in some ways work backwards from that. The companies that I've seen be most successful have taken that sort of like working backwards mentality.
So where do you see the most value?
I think there's so many different areas for value. It all depends on the organizations and what their primary use cases are and what their business models are. But certainly with respect to operations, where you have to have a first draft that can be facilitated by generative AI, that's been an area that there's been a lot of traction. You can have a human in the loop to finalize that content, whether it's an image or a copy, what have you. And that also allows for hyper-personalization as well. So this notion of first draft content creation is really meaningful and got a lot of traction. Of course, customer service is an area that a lot of people have seen a lot of success. Software development. So folks like Google and Amazon have quoted that they have 30% of their code being created by generative AI. So for those organizations that are really leaning into engineering and software development, that certainly is going to be a critical area for them. And then finally, an area that we don't talk about a lot, but data analysis. So analysts being able to get insights and iterating, having speed to insight more quickly because generative AI helps them assess and deal with all these disparate data sources more quickly. That's going to be an area that I could definitely see getting a lot of traction.
Thank you so much.
Sure.